London, 1857. Well, this place has changed since I was last here. 1851, Cybermen invasion. Of course, they failed. They built a giant robot. Cybership, it was a dreadnought class, I believe. Had to send it into the time vortex. Cybermen are all but dead now. Well, what's gonna happen now? Uh-oh, come on, Mika, I think we've got work to do.
Do we?
Oh no.
Do we?
Stay back, Mika. I've killed Cybermen before. What the hell? Okay, who the hell are you? My name is John Lesworth. It's a pleasure to finally meet you, Doctor. I'm sorry, you know who I am? Of course, everyone in London knows who you are. Can we again? The Cybermen, 1851? That was you, right? I see, you must have been there that night. I was 7 years younger. We've been preparing for your return, Doctor. Okay, we? Yeah. As someone who'd quite like to see you, an old friend of yours.
Our scans indicate the TARDIS has touched down on London soil. The Doctor has arrived. Send a cyber unit to delete them. Our cyber unit was deleted. We must step into the school squadron of soldiers. Understood.
Wow, this is a nice place. Tell me about it, Doctor. It's good to see you. Jackson Lake. It's been too long. Yes, it's been what... I don't know how long it's been, Doctor. You're time travel, but I don't know how long it's been. Yeah. Well, last time I saw you, you were skinny and you had brown hair. Well, you know what they say about regeneration? It's a lottery. So London looks quite different. What happened here? You all sit down, Doctor. You and I have a lot to catch up on. So Jackson, you really gonna tell me what happened here? It's quite a story, Doctor. After the fall of Ms. Hartkin and the Cyber King, there was some cyber wreckage left, and a whole cache of info stamps. So what'd you do with it? Well, roughly a year after you left, and after the cyber attack, I was met by John Lesworth, the guy you just met. He seeked to use all the cyber tech for his own need to protect London. Okay. So, is that why London's basically changed? Well, yes. We actually managed to use some of the technology to improve the city. Nice. So does that mean you've improved all the technology and weapons? I wouldn't say that, it's a slow process. Well. So what happened to your son? What was his name? Frederick? Yeah. Well, Frederick grew slightly older last time you were here, Doctor. He was only 8 years old. He went to go and stay with some relatives in Scotland. Yeah. Hey, speaking of which, what happened to your friend? What was her name? Rosita, was it? Yes. Rosita left for pastures new, Doctor. She went to Africa to go and discover her heritage. It turns out she did have some heritage there. Plus, not everyone in the country was kind to her here. Yeah. Anyway, it's been good to see you. Indeed. I do hope you'll be sticking around for a bit, Doctor. It'd be good to catch up. Yeah, sure, that'd be great. I don't really have anything on my schedule anyway. So tell me, Doctor, what incarnation are you now? And let me think here. Well, right now, I think I'm on my 14th, 13th incarnation. I thought you only had 12 generations. What's that, Mika? Doctor, you need to see this. What is it? Mika? Jackson, I think this could be trouble. I'm on my way. Oh no. The Cybermen.
It is the Doctor. Delayed.
What do you want?
We are going to go into the world.
Yeah, you said that last time. Didn't exactly work out, did it?
Delayed.
Run! My word, Doctor, you certainly redecorated in here. Hey, believe you me. Right, let's get to work. Mika, pull the switch. So, Doctor, what's the plan? I don't know. We need to find where those Cybermen were coming from first. Alright. I'm gonna use the TARDIS to run a trace on the Cybermen. Ooh, here we go. What is it? Doctor, what is it? I think we found the Cybermen. So, good news is there's only a small number of them left. What's the bad news? There's the Cyberman command ship right above the Earth. Oh god, what's it gonna do? I don't know. That's what we're gonna find out. More or less, that's what I'm gonna go find out. I've locked onto the Cybermen command ship. We're gonna head there now. Doctor, are you insane? That's a suicide mission. No, Jackson. I just want to figure out what they're up to. Alright, put them up, Cybermen. The Cyber Leader. Can't say it's a pleasure. Jeez, I feel sorry for you. Alright. First question. How would you survive the Cyber King?
We ordered a squadron to them. They are weak, incompatible Cyber units.
Oh, great. Cybermen who turn on their own kind. Okay, so what's your dastardly plan now?
We will delete the human race.
Why delete them? Wouldn't you want to convert them into new Cybermen?
No. We have enough Cyber units for the Cyber Wars.
Oh, I get it. So that war's still going on, is it? Even after I intervened?
You never intervened in the Cyber Wars, Doctor.
Well, maybe this face didn't, but maybe 2 faces ago I did. Right. I'm giving you one warning. Leave Earth now. I can find you a different world to convert. I can find you a new home.
We didn't want a new home, Doctor. We wanted to leave the human race. And we become the new Cybermen.
But you just said you didn't need new Cyber units. God, you Cybermen are so tricky these days. Okay, thanks to my little visit, we finally know what the Cybermen's plans are. So what is it, Doctor? Well, the Cybermen keep saying they're going to convert the world into Cybermen, but the question is, how are they going to do that? They don't really have any raw materials. Unless... I've seen that kind of Cybermen command ship before. before this face, the face before this one, I was with an old friend of mine, Captain Jack. Me and him had to take down a whole squadron of Cybermen. It was similar to the same command ship. Like, there was a command ship filled with Cybermen. They had conversion units on there. Oh god, I know what they're gonna do. What are they going to do, Doctor? What is it? They're gonna capture all of London and convert them into cyber units. Then we've got to stop them. Yeah, exactly, but how? Unless... what is it, Doctor? I've got schematics for the Cybermen command ship. If I ever met them again, I thought I could find a weakness. Haha, here we go. Oh god. Doctor, what is it now? The Cybermen command ship is powered by a planet core engine. Even destroying it will cause a chain reaction and can consume galaxies. We've got to find a way behind that. Got to find a way around. Jackson? I've got an idea. Okay, here's the plan. Mika, I need you to man the TARDIS controls. I need you to transmit me and Jackson on board to the Cybermen command ship. Get us close enough so you can transmit us on board. What's the plan? We're gonna plug the dimension vault into the planet core engine. That will stabilize it so it doesn't cause any chain reaction. But the core engine is gonna collapse in on itself and take the cyber ship with it. Doctor, that's the most insane and convoluted plan you've come up with. You should have seen my tent body. I came up with way more convoluted plans than that. Alright, Jackson. It's clear. Right, what's the plan? Alright. We're gonna need to modify the dimension vault somehow. If I can modify it, we can then attach it to the core engine. And what's that going to do? Well, for starters, it's actually going to stabilize the core engine. Then, we'll need to somehow activate the dimension vault. Then the core will collapse in on itself, and in theory, it should destroy the whole ship. But how are we gonna get off? That's where Mika comes in, you see. If I'm right, Mika can transmit us back on board before the ship blows up. That's an interesting plan, Doctor.
Scanners indicate the Doctor is on the ship. He has the dimension vault. We must obey him.
Doctor, they know we're here. We have to go. We're almost done. I'm sorry. For what? No. Oh god, that ship's hurtling towards Earth. I don't know, Mika, but it might cause something similar to what happened in 65 million BC. That's gonna wipe out all of Earth, just like what the meteor did to the dinosaurs. We need to stop that ship. Mika, where should we go next? Ancient Egypt? Henry VIII? Red Skies of the Cotopaxians?